Hi everyone, for today's Artrageous Art Lesson, we get to go inside here. Do you know what this is? We're actually going to be traveling not just through what you see behind me, but we're also going to be traveling back through time, over 40,000 years ago, when the first men created the first type of artwork ever made in the history of the world. Those were the cave paintings, and this is the famous cave of Lascaux. We get to go on a tour through the cave today, look at some of these amazing cave paintings, and I'm going to share with you a book that I actually wrote and illustrated about how this cave was discovered, and then you're going to get to do your very own cave painting. So I'm so excited today because we get to learn about the history of art, and you get to be a part of that by making your own awesome artwork. So let's step inside the cave and see what these ancient, ancient cave paintings look like. So when you walk through, first of all, in a cave, it's pitch black. So scientists don't know why the cavemen made these paintings, but we do know that these were made before pencils were invented, paintbrushes, or any of the things that we get to use today. So despite not having all those amazing tools, this artwork was absolutely incredible. So if you look very closely, you can see paintings of animals, sometimes handprints, sometimes people, and we can only guess why the cave painters made these beautiful pieces of artwork. So my book that I'm going to share with you, it was my goal to write this awesome book, is all about how this cave was discovered. And after I read you the book, then we're going to get started on your very own cave painting. So, are you ready to get started? Okay. The Discovery of Lascaux by Jamie Wardley. Bonjour, my name is Robot. I know I don't look like a robot, I'm a dog. I heard that you wanted to find out how the famous cave of Lascaux was discovered. Well, who better than to tell you than me, the dog who discovered it. First, let's find out where this story takes place. The cave of Lascaux is located in the southern part of France, which is located on the continent of Europe. It all started on a chilly day in September. My master, Marcel, excitedly told me we were going on an adventure through the woods near our village of Montagnac. As we entered the dim forest, Marcel described a legend of a hidden treasure buried somewhere in the woods. I wanted so badly for Marcel to be pleased with me. I was determined to help him find the treasure. I sniffed every rock, every tree, but found nothing unusual. Just as we turned to head home, I caught a whiff of something wet, earthy, and old. It was a large hidden crevice under some branches and rocks. Suddenly, I started sliding down a slippery slope of dirt and rocks. With a loud yelp, I landed hard on my tail at the bottom of a deep, narrow hole in the ground. Robot, are you okay? Hang on, boy. I'll run back to the village for help, Marcel shouted as he scrambled to his feet and ran off towards Montagnac. Marcel quickly found his three friends, Jacques, George, and Simone. They ran as fast as they could back to the crevice where I was waiting. Jacques brought his oil lamp to light their way. Robot's going to be okay, Jacques reassured Marcel as he handed him the oil lamp. One by one, Marcel and his three friends carefully wiggled down the narrow opening. Once at the bottom, Marcel scooped me into his arms and squeezed me tightly. Robot, you're okay. And you found a secret tunnel, Marcel exclaimed. Marcel, I bet this is the cave with the hidden treasure, Jacques whispered. His voice echoed through what seemed to be a deep cavern.
caves are dark and dangerous, George whined. We will stay together and be careful, Simone reassured him. Plus, we have the lamp to light our way. The narrow passageway led to a huge opening. As Marcel raised the oil lamp high above his head, the walls surrounding us were bathed in light. We all gasped at what we saw. All along the rocky walls were huge drawings of strange-looking deer, horses, and cattle. Some looked like they were running. The animals were colored with rich brown hues and velvety blacks, oranges, reds, and brilliant whites. Now that's just a preview of the book. If you want to hear more about this story, you can go on Amazon.com and look up The Discovery of Lascaux. Now we get to learn how to make our own cave painting using some of the images and symbols that we saw in the book and in our tour of the cave. To make your very own cave painting, what we're going to be using first is pencil. We always want to draw with pencil first. But we, instead of drawing on white paper, we want our cave paintings to look like they were really drawn by the cavemen 40,000 years ago, and they only drew on the side of a rock. So instead of drawing on white paper, we have this brown paper that I actually recycled, and it's really good for drawing. So the first thing that I want to do is always the same. I pick up my pencil and I write my name on the back. Now, the paper was in a roll, so it's kind of curling up. So you might want to lay something down to keep it from rolling over. So I have some glue and maybe a marker over here. Now, there are lots of different types of animals in the cave paintings. And you can see this one looks almost like a buffalo or a bull. This one is the actual skeleton or the skull of the animal. And this one looks sort of like a deer. So with your cave painting, I've printed off some different animals that you can look at, but remember, these animals didn't have lots of details. They were very simple because they didn't have pencils back then or paintbrushes. So what we want to do is pick an animal or a shape, and we want to draw it really big on our brown paper. So I'm going to look at some of these shapes and see, we have, there's the bison, I think that is. Some of these are like prehistoric animals. I really like that horse too. So I'm going to try to do the horse. This one right here, I think I can do that one. There's also some other shapes over here that you might want to use. Some of them look like figures, but I'm going to try the horse. So I'm going to look at the shapes. That looks like there's a curved line for the back. So you can start with lines or shapes. But you don't have to add eyes or details because these are just, the cave paintings were pretty simple. Okay, so now I have the basic shape of the horse. The next thing I'm going to use are oil pastels. And I want to start with colors that they had back then in the caves. And these are called neutral colors. White, brown, black are all neutral colors. So I want to start with those. And then I might want to add a little bit of white. I'm not drawing any eyes or any other details. And then, of course, I want to use black. Thank you. Okay, so now once I have my horse drawn, I could add some other symbols, but the next thing that you're gonna do is actually, right now the shape of your paper is kind of like a rectangle. Now that is called a geometric shape. A rock is a natural shape. So I wanna really carefully, you could cut the corners, but I like tearing the paper because tearing the paper gives my cave painting a nice natural shape. So we're looking for a natural shape or an organic shape, and I'm just tearing off the corners. Now I'm gonna recycle those. Now my paper looks good, but it doesn't look like a rock because it's smooth. I want my paper texture, and texture is one of the elements of art. I want it to be bumpy. So now watch closely. What am I gonna do with my paper? I'm actually going to crumble it up. So you crumble your paper and you squeeze it and you just keep crumbling it until it feels nice and bumpy like a rock. Now when you open it, you wanna be careful when you open your cave painting because you don't want your paper to tear. But this is fun. I'm really making it bumpy and giving it lots of texture. Now I'm gonna open it up and see how it looks. Oh, look at that, isn't that cool? Now, the cool thing about oil pastels is that you can use your finger and you can rub the oil pastels across the texture and the oil pastels will make it look just like a real rock. So the more you rub it, the more it looks like a rock. And you can see that texture. Now, last year we did a really cool project called The Cave of Art, where we actually used black lights to make these glow in the dark. Now, these will not glow in the dark unless we add the neon paint. Now, back in the caveman days, they didn't have neon colors. They only had neutral colors. But after you're done crumbling your paper and rubbing the texture, you can add some of the neon paint around your animal, not on top of it, so that yours will actually glow in the dark. Once you're finished adding the neon paint, you glue it onto a black piece of paper, and you want to make sure you write your name, and you will have your very own cave painting. So, good luck making your cave painting. I hope that you liked learning about the first type of artwork ever invented, and I hope you had fun making your own cave painting. So good luck and get started.